Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan pasca sarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang, Selasa 9 November 2021, program studi ilmu pendidikan bahasa S3. Atas nama Saudari Diah Astrianti, SPD, MPD, dimulai. Sekretaris penguji melaporkan kepada ketua penguji bahwa ujian promosi doktor pendidikan siap dimulai.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, Bapak Rektor yang amat cendekia, Bapak Ibu penguji yang sangat terpelajar, para tamu undangan yang kami hormati, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin, pada hari ini Selasa 9 November 2021 program studi Ilmu Pendidikan Bahasa S3 Pasca Sarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang mengajukan Saudari Diah Adrianti, SPD, MPD sebagai promovenda untuk dapat diujikan disertasinya yang berjudul The Effect of Advanced Organizer, Graphic Organizer, and Combination of Advanced Organizer and Graphic Organizer on Listening Comprehension of Students with Different and Safety Levels. Saya laporkan kepada Bapak Rektor dan para penguji bahwa promovenda telah menyelesaikan semua perkuliahan serta telah menjalani beberapa tahapan pengujian status sebelumnya di Pasca Sarjana UNES dan kesemuanya dinyatakan lulus serta telah memenuhi syarat untuk ujian disertasi tahap 2 ini. Oleh karena itu, saya mohon Bapak Rektor selaku Ketua Penguji untuk membuka dan sekaligus memimpin ujian disertasi secara resmi. Akhirul kalam, wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saudara Promovenda, Bapak Rektor hari ini ada acara di luar Semarang, sehingga beliau tidak bisa langsung untuk membuka dan memimpin ujian. Beliau menugasi saya untuk memanggili beliau untuk membuka dan memimpin ujian. Apakah saudari bersedia?
Bersedia, Prof.
Baik. Terima kasih. Sebelum ujian ini saya buka, saya bertanya dulu pada saudari, apakah saudari dalam keadaan sehat jasmani rohani?
Alhamdulillah, Prof. Sehat, Prof.
Sehat. Apakah benar karya ilmiah yang nanti saudara pertahankan adalah karya asli saudari sendiri?
Benar, Prof.
Baik, silakan saudari dari baca surat pernyataan keaslian, lalu tanda tangani di atas meterai.
Baik, Prof. Terima kasih, Prof. atas waktunya. Pernyataan keaslian, dengan ini saya, nama Diah Astrianti, NIM 02016170002, Program Studi Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris, menyatakan bahwa yang tertulis dalam disertasi yang berjudul The Effect of Advanced Organizer, Graphic Organizer, and Combinations of Advanced Organizer and Graphic Organizer on Listening Comprehension of Students with Different Anxiety Levels. Ini benar-benar karya saya sendiri, bukan jiplakan dari karya tulis lain atau pengutipan dengan cara-cara yang tidak sesuai dengan etika keilmuan yang berlaku, baik sebagian atau seluruhnya. Pendapat atau temuan orang lain yang terdapat dalam disertasi ini dikutip atau dirujuk berdasarkan kode etik ilmiah. Atas pernyataan ini, saya secara pribadi siap menanggung resiko atau sanksi hukum yang dijatuhkan apabila ditemukan adanya pelanggaran terhadap etika keilmuan dalam karya ini. Semarang, 9 November 2021, yang membuat pernyataan dia, Astrianti.
Ya, cukup. Cukup, ya. Sudah siap ujian ya, Nari?
Insya Allah siap, Prof.
Baik, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. ujian promosi doktor pendidikan Saudari Diah Astrianti SPD MPD secara resmi saya nyatakan dibuka. Berikut saya bacakan tim penguji saudari Ketua Profesor Dr. Faturrahman Imhum, Sekretaris Profesor Dr. Agus Nuryadin Imhum, anggota 1 Profesor Dr. Soekarno MSI. Dia sudah menguji kemarin dan sudah mengirimkan nilai ke saya. 2 Profesor Dr. Januarius Mujianto Imhum. Makasih perhatian ya. 3 Dr. Eko Handoyo MSI sebagai penguji 3.
Ya, Pak Ketua.
Terima kasih, Pak Eko. 4 Dr. Joko Sutopo MSI sebagai penguji 4. Makasih, Pak Joko.
Sama-sama, Prof.
5 Profesor Dr. Abdurrahman Faridi MPD sebagai penguji 5. Apakah sudah bergabung? Mudah-mudahan segera bisa bergabung, Prof. Faridi. 6 Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini MPD sebagai penguji 6. Makasih, Prof. Dwi Rukmini. Berikut silakan Saudari Promo Benda untuk berdoa terlebih dahulu. Kalau sudah, silakan saudara paparkan karya saudari, waktu maksimal 15 menit.
Baik, Prof. Okay, thank you very much, Prof. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The Honorable Professor Dr. Agus Nuryadin Imhum, The Honorable Professor Dr. Januarius Mujianto Imhum, The Honorable Dr. Eko Handoyo MSI, The Honorable Dr. Joko Sutopo MSI, The Honorable Professor Dr. Abdurrahman Faridi MPD, and The Honorable Professor Dr. Dwi Rukmini MPD. Okay, thank you very much for the opportunity given to me. Today, I would like to present the result report of my dissertations with the title The Effect of Advanced Organizer, Graphic Organizer, and Combinations of Advanced Organizer and Graphic Organizer on Listening Comprehensions of Students with Different Anxiety Levels. As mentioned in the research title, the researcher focused on listening comprehension because the teaching listening is an important and challenging process for most of the teachers. Listening is important for the students' communications in their daily life and in their classroom. It is because the students gain a large portions of information, understanding, education through listening in teaching and learning process. Besides that, this research was conducted under several reasons. The first is from the observations conducted in IKI PGRI Pontianak, the researcher found that the students did not familiar with the material given by the teacher. As the result, they difficult in finishing the task given by the teacher. And then the students also reluctant to take part in the discussions. That is why the classroom become passive and the students feel nervous and afraid that they will give the wrong answers on the task. Another point is that there are still a few studies were conducted in investigating the importance of building background knowledge in teaching listening comprehensions. And then there is no studies were conducted on the combinations of advanced organizer and graphic organizer in teaching listening. These studies have 12 research questions. The first is, how significant is the effect of the combinations of advanced organizer and graphic organizer in teaching listening comprehension? And then the second is the effect the significant difference between the combinations and the advanced organizer. The third research question is the effect, the significant difference between the combinations and the graphic organizer. And then the fourth research question is the significant difference among the combinations and the advanced organizer and the graphic organizer. And the fifth research question is the significant difference, no, it is the significance of the combinations of advanced organizer and graphic organizer to the students with high listening anxiety. And then the second research question is the combinations of advanced organizer and graphic organizer to the students with low level anxiety. The seventh research question was the significant difference between the combinations and the advanced organizer to the students with high listening anxiety. And then the eighth research question is the significant difference between the combinations and the advanced organizer to the students with low level anxiety. The ninth research question is the significant difference between the combinations and the graphic organizer to the students with high listening anxiety. And then the 10th is the significant difference between the combinations and the graphic organizer to the students with low level anxiety. The 11th research question is the significant difference among the combinations of advanced organizer and graphic organizer and the advanced organizer and the graphic organizer to the students with high and low listening anxiety. And then the last research question is about interactions between the organizer and the students' listening anxiety. Here is the theoretical framework of the study. This study was focused on the teaching listening to the third semester students of IKIP PGRI Pontianak. And then the researcher used three kinds of organizer. The first is the combinations of advanced organizer and graphic organizer. And then the second was the advanced organizer, and the third is the graphic organizer. These three kinds of organizers were used to teach the students with high listening anxiety level and the students with low listening anxiety level. With the result is the students' listening achievement. Specifically, the researcher applied 2x3 factorial design to find out the effect of the combinations implementations to the students' listening achievement and the students' listening anxiety. The population and the sample. The populations are taken from the 6 classes of the third semester students of IKIP PGRI Pontianak in the academic year of 2019 and 2020. Well, the sample were 3 classes out of 4 classes, which are homogeneous, that is chosen by using cluster random sampling. And then the variables of the research, there are 3 kinds of variables in the study. The first is the independent variables of which consists of the combinations, the advanced organizer and the graphic organizer. And then the dependent variable is the effect of the student's listening comprehension. And then the moderator variable is the student's listening anxiety. The research instruments, there are 2 kinds of research instruments in these studies. There are the test of the student's listening comprehension and the questionnaire of the student's listening anxiety. The technique of data analysis. In analyzing the data, the scores of the students' listening test were analyzed by using descriptive statistics and the inferential statistic. Here are the research findings and the discussions of this study. The first research findings indicate that the T obtained is higher than the T table. It means that there is a significant effect between the students' pre-test and post-test after taught by using combinations of advanced organizer and graphic organizer. These findings supported by Mahmoud and Rouhani, which mentions that the use of 2 strategies, especially different kind of organizer in one organization presentations, can provide a bunch of information to the students. And then the second research findings indicate that the T obtained is lower than the T table. It means that there is no significant difference between the combinations and the advanced organizer. The third research findings indicate that the T obtained is higher than the T table. It means that there is significant difference between the combinations and the graphic organizer to the students' listening comprehension. And then the fourth research finding indicate that the F obtained is higher than the F table. It means that there is significant difference among the 3 of the organizers. The fifth research findings indicate that the tea obtained is higher than the tea table. It means that there is significant difference. There is significant effect of the combinations to the students with high level of anxiety. And then the sixth research research findings showed that the tea obtained is higher than the tea table. It means that there is significant effect of the combination to the students' listening comprehension who have low level anxiety. And then the seventh research findings indicate that the tea obtained is lower than the tea table. It means that there is no, there is no significant difference between the combinations and the advanced organizer to the students with high level anxiety. And then the eighth research findings indicate that the tea obtained is lower than the tea table. It is also indicated that there is no significant difference between the combinations and the advanced organizer in adding effect to the students with low level anxiety. The ninth research question, research findings was the tea obtained is lower than the tea table. It means that there is no significant difference between the combinations and graphic organizer in adding effect to the students with high listening anxiety. The same as number research findings number 10, that the tea obtained is also lower than the tea table. So there is no significant difference between the combinations and graphic organizer to the students with low level anxiety. The 11 research findings indicate that the F obtained between the columns is higher than the F table. It means that there is significant difference among the three organizer, but unfortunately that there is no significant difference between the students who have high listening anxiety and low listening anxiety. The 12 research questions, research findings was indicated that the F obtained of interactions is lower than the F table. It means that there is no interactions between the organizer and the students listening anxiety. It is supported by Papa Mihail in 2016, who believed that English language anxiety is multidimensional, which affect the students from different situations and contexts. As the nature of English language anxiety possibly affects the students in many different levels, which require a variety of treatment and teaching strategies. Conclusions, there are 12 conclusions in study, but to save the time, I make it into three. The first is that it was proved that the combinations of narrations and graphics in one organizer helps the students to think critically to build bigger knowledge as the foundations to face the information in listening activity. And then there is a significant difference among the three organizer, but advanced organizer adds more effect to the students' listening comprehensions rather than the combinations. It is because the activities on each phase of in advanced organizer give benefit for the students, start from getting the students' attentions and being ready to accept new information related to the material and strengthening the cognitive organization, where the students can connect the new learning material to their existing information. And then there is no interactions between the organizer and the students' listening anxiety, because language anxiety is multidimensional, which affect the students' performance from different situations and contexts. It means that the feeling of anxiety of a student might be different from another student's. That is why the associations between strategies and learning may vary as a function of a person's other attributes. There are four recommendations. The first is the further study needs to be conducted on the use of the combinations advanced organizer and graphic organizer in teaching listening as a tool of material introductions. And then the second, a further study of the combinations advanced organizer and graphic organizer can be conducted fit from the students' learning preferences, whether they prefer to visual or audiovisual learning style. And then the third, the teacher should investigate deeper on the students' listening anxiety, such as the cause of the anxiety. And then the fourth, Research that focuses on advanced organizer and graphic organizer or the combinations of the two organizers by looking at another psychological factors that affects the students. I think that's all from me. Thank you very much for the attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Baik, berikut tanya jawab dari para penguji dengan penguji. Dimulai dari penguji Profesor Dr. Yanuarius Mujianto, M.Hum. Dipersilakan Prof. Yan, waktu maksimal 10 menit.
Terima kasih Prof. Agus Nuryatin for the time to examine the Diakur Diastri Astrianti. Okay. First of all, I should like to congratulate Diah Adrianti for finishing the draft, the dissertation draft. So you are allowed to be here for this promotion. Point that I'd like to ask you is about your choice of IKIP PGRI Pontianak. Why should it be IKIP PGRI Pontianak, not other institutions?
Okay, thank you very much for the question, Prof. The first reason, because I'm teaching there as I am a lecturer there, and then I teach listening comprehensions
The academic reason. Yeah, academic reason. It's not because you are teaching there, but should be a tuition.
Yes, because from my experience and also from my previous observations at the second semester students at that time, it seems that there is no progressions from the students' achievement in listening comprehensions. It means that it is obviously appear that the students still have difficulties in listening comprehension courses. So I believe that if I conduct the study in these institutions, then I can try to contribute to share another strategies to improve the students' listening comprehension achievement.
Okay, so what do you contribute to the institution on the basis of your study?
Previously, I asked with the lecturers there whether they ever try to build or to add the students with background knowledge before they give the students the task to be done. It seems that there is the lecturers never give the students enough information about the topic or the material that they are going to study. It seems that the students, the lecturers only mentions the topic of the material at the time and then explain to the students about what should they do dealing with the task, and then start the listening activity. So I would like to make, or I would like to show to other lecturers that teaching listening is not testing the students the students about their pronunciations or their vocabulary's understanding. It is about how we give them sufficient information, and then we try make them to do the task based on the knowledge, and then the students can anchor it to the new information that they receive from the recording.
Okay, now let us talk about the essence of your dissertation. Yeah, first is about the use of the terminology advance, yeah, advance organizer, yeah, advance. What is the difference between advance without T and advance with T? Have you checked it in your dictionary or not? If not then check it sometime later, right? Yeah.
Advanced
I just want to make sure whether you have to use advanced with D or without D. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Prof, for the questions. Advanced without D means that we give something before or in front or sebelum. But advanced is different with D. Some things that higher than the higher level of something.
Okay, right. Yeah. Okay. It means that you understand. Yeah. What is meant by advance without T and advance with T, right? Yeah. So you are right to use advance organizer, even though this terminology has been used by the expert, right? Yeah. But you are right. Your explanation is right. Okay. And then second terminology that is available here is about the use of bibliography. Yeah. Okay. What is the difference between bibliography and references? Okay. In your dissertation here, you use the term bibliography. Yeah.
Thank you, Prof.
Okay. Have you checked it or not? Have you checked it or not? Check the meaning of the difference between bibliography and references. If not, then check it sometime later.
I haven't checked it yet, Prof, but from the discussions from my friends, that reference means that a list of resources that we take from the article or the books, but it still need to be added, while bibliography means that a list of references that we take and it is already finished or done. It means that we did not, or we will not add more.
All right. Okay. So which one is more appropriate, to use references or bibliography?
Bibliography.
Okay. In your work, right? Which one is more appropriate, bibliography or references?
Bibliography
or references? Yeah.
Bibliography, bro.
Okay. Check it again in your dictionary. Yeah.
Okay.
Right. Now we are talking about homogeneity and heterogeneity of tests that you used, in your throughout your thesis, chapter 4, right? You are talking about homogeneity and heterogeneity tests, right? Or as the requirement, to use a certain statistical computation, okay. Let's say the data you have is homogeneous, okay. Then what test did you use in your study?
After we found that the data is homogeneous, we can proceed to the next data, analysis, such as the inferential statistics. It just depends on in what kind of research questions that we have. So in inferential statistics, I used the test of non-independent sample and the test of independent sample, and also the ANOVA. So after we found out that the data is homogeneous, we can proceed to make or to analyze the data into which kind of inferential statistic that we need to analyze.
Did you find out that most of the data in your study are homogeneous or heterogeneous?
Homogeneous, bro.
Homogeneous. So, so what does it mean? If your data are all homogeneous, then what does it mean?
It means that from the set of the data, that the student's achievement is not too jomplang. So it means that there is no students who have very high scores, and also did not have a very low score. It means that the students have more likely like close, whether it is high and then low, the range is not too tidak terlalu kentara, yang paling tinggi sama yang paling rendahnya, Prof.
Okay, now next question is about the relation between advanced organizer and anxiety. Yeah, advanced organizer and anxiety. What sort of relation is it? Is it causal relation or what sort of relation?
I think that it is a causal relationship, sir, because that when the students know about what they are going to deal with the recording or with the listening or with the task, so they the feeling that they have is no longer about hesitate or confused, but it is curiosity whether which kind of
do you mean to say good advanced organizer means high anxiety or means low anxiety?
It's a good advanced organizer means that the students have low
anxiety. See what I mean? Low anxiety, all right, thank you very much for your answers, and terima kasih Prof. Agus Nuryatin for the time given to me. Thank you
very much, Prof.
Terima kasih, Prof. Yan. Penguji berikut, Dr. Eko Handoyo, MSc, dipersilakan Pak Eko, waktu maksimal 10 menit. Suaranya, Pak Eko.
Suaranya masih belum terdengar, Prof.
Iya. Iya, tapi tak buka, nggak bisa-bisa kok. Maaf. Terima kasih, Prof. Agus Nuryatin, Bapak-Ibu para penguji yang hormati. Congratulations, Mbak Diah Astrianti.
Thank you, Prof.
Yeah, you have successfully taken the open exam. Your dissertation is good and complete, but as I am examiner, of course I must ask you several questions. Yeah.
Yes, bro.
Yeah, are you ready? Yeah. Okay, why you are interested in research the topic?
Okay, thank you very much, Prof, for the questions. Why I interested with the topic is the focus of my topic is about listening comprehension. It is because I'm curious why the students often think that listening comprehension is a difficult courses or difficult lesson for them to be mastered. It is also any relation with my experience when I am as a student, also as the lecturer who teach my students with listening comprehensions. It seems that no matter how easy the material that we use or I use, still the students feel that listening is difficult for them. So when I read about Ausubel's book about meaningful learning, I found out that there is a strategy called advanced organizer, which consists of a set of informations that it is important for the students to know or to have before they do the listening activity. So I think it's not fair if we give them the listening task without knowing what kind of informations that they already have about the topic or the material. Okay. So that is why I use advanced organizer and graphic organizer, and also combine between those two organizer.
Okay. Enough. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Prof.
Okay. Next. Is the listening ability of student at IKPGRI Pontianak weak? So you suggest the need for this research?
Yes,
sorry.
Prof.
Sorry, sensitive question.
It's okay.
Do you agree that student input at IKPGRI is low?
happen in listening comprehension.
Yeah, related listening.
Because the students are coming from a very rural area. I'm afraid that they have not sufficient
listening activity and their previous high school. So when they are joining in IKIP PGRI Pontianak, they feel surprised while listening
comprehension. But people in rural area is not always is low competent, yeah?
Yes, Prof. But I think that it is because of the sources of the material, Prof.
Okay. What does the lecturer do to process low input into great output in IKIP PGRI related English competence?
Of course, it is a work hard for all of us in IKIP PGRI Pontianak to improve the students' English input, Prof. So there are lots of activity that the Prodi program for that, like tutoring, like mentoring, or also about how to give the students different experience in using English outside of the classroom. So we program those kind of activities. Meanwhile, in the classroom itself, we try to find interesting way to introduce the material or to teach the material, so the students will become more active rather than feel afraid or passive in the classroom.
And you found a weakness, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, weakness of competence. Okay. Next. Why did you choose listening to anxiety as one of the variables in your research?
Because listening comprehension is a very complex process, Prof. Very complex process where there are lots of activity that the students have to overcome in one time. First, they have to receive the information.
Yeah. What is the significance for your research?
The significance of listening. Yes, because of the difficulties of the listening comprehensions, so the students' listening anxiety arise from the listening comprehension problem. So anxiety is only one of psychological factors that close to the nature of the materials in listening comprehension.
Okay. In your research, how is the effect of teaching using EO and GO on students who have low listening anxiety and high listening anxiety?
Okay, thank you, Prof. From the research findings that I analyzed in my research, it is found out that from those three kinds of organizers, those three organizers effective in teaching listening comprehensions for both the students with high and low listening anxiety. But when the researcher find out the difference, the differences, the significant difference among those three organizers, it is resulted that the advanced organizer add effect more rather than the combinations and the graphic organizer. Prof.
Okay. What are the strength and weakness of your research?
Okay, the strengths and the weaknesses, especially in the use of the combinations of advanced organizer and graphic organizer, is that the time length of the material introductions is too long for the students because it is two organizers combined into one organization's presentation. So, and then the material that the researcher or the lecturer introduced to the students is also too long that the students feel bored and too much. There are too much information that they have to receive. That is why when they when the advanced organizer presented, it seems that it is more effective rather than the combinations.
Okay. Can the result of your research be generalized to another subject?
Yes, Prof. Of course, it can be used for another subject like reading comprehension, Prof.
Reading comprehension, maybe writing.
Writing, I think it is possible, but the most appropriate is in receptive skill, Prof. Like listening and reading.
Okay, what is the theoretical contribution of your dissertation?
The contribution of my research is that these studies can give enlightenment to the lecturer that there is another strategies that we can use in listening comprehension, such as these organizers. So the lecturers can try to use this kind of organizer to teach listening comprehension in their classroom.
Okay, congratulations, Mbak Dia Astrianti. My question is enough. Saya kembali kepada Pak Direktur. Terima kasih Pak Direktur. Matur nuwun.
Oke, terima kasih. Pak Eko, penguji berikut Pak Dr. Joko Sutopo MSI. Dipersilakan Pak Joko waktu maksimal 10 menit.
Terima kasih, Prof. Halo, Dia.
Halo, Pak.
Congratulations for you having completed this draft of dissertations.
Thank you, Bapak.
I have some comments and questions for you. Let me start from my comments. Yeah. Technically, your dissertations needs improving in a number of introductions of each of the chapter. You give one information only. Meanwhile, the requirement of a chapter should have been at least two informations. You can have a look at each of the chapter. You say at length, but you say it in one sentence only. Why don't you make it into two or three so that you are qualified to say as a paragraph? Yeah.
Okay.
See chapter one, chapter two, chapter three, chapter four, as well as chapter five. Okay. Make it happen. All right. Then next comment is on your discussions sections. Yeah, you begin your discussion sections by saying by mentioning subtitles. Say for example, there is a significant effect between the students. Blah 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 blah. Yeah, I don't think it is a title. It is a phrase. It is a sentence. You do not need to say so. Therefore, you can just say the significant effect between blah, blah, blah. There is no need for you to say there is. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You can make some revision on that. Yeah? Yeah. And the next comment or the last comment is on your references. I'm afraid you do not refer to 7 editions of APA APA styles of references. Yeah, so you can have a look at the say for example reference number one. This is taken from a journal, right? But yep. you say or you write it. You write the title of the article by using capital letters all the time. I don't think it is. Not the way 7th edition of APA styles of references. You can make some revision on that, okay?
Yes, Papa.
Yeah, that's it, my comment. My question now is a little bit crucial, yeah? You know, to my impressions, your study is quite technical. It's quite technical, since you are or your reference since your dissertation is very quantitative, yeah, whereas your study is English education, of which the scale of discourse is the big issue or the main issue. That's my impression, yeah. And I was also worrying about your study, because you terminate your study on the level of technical ones. Meanwhile, in a few minutes, you are expected to say something at the level of philosophy. At the level of philosophy, yeah. So you need to touch this area to make it different from graduate level. You are supposed to be postgraduate level, okay? So try to explore and to develop your study into the level of philosophy. I think it is challenging but promising. I'm sure you can make it, yeah. So philosophy of listening, for example, because your issue is listening comprehension, yeah. And since Plato was alive, issue of listening has been the central discussion. So you can imagine how important it is, the philosophy of listening. Yeah, the philosophy of listening is basically a set of beliefs that fall into four categories. Category number one is the aim of listening. Number two is the nature of listening. Number three is the role of the listener. And number four is the relation between listener and speaker. So now I would like you to say something on my question as far as you can. Yeah. What is the aim of listening philosophically?
Okay. Philosophically, thank you, Bapak, for the questions. Philosophically, the use of listening comprehensions is to be able to interact with one person to another, and then to provide understanding or information for the listeners. By listening to the material given to them.
Is it? I think that's all, Baba. Okay, at least you have answered my question. If I you cannot...
I think I need to explore more about the philosophy of listening comprehension, yeah. Baba.
Yeah, my second question then now. What is the... nature of listening?
The nature of listening is the activity where someone receive informations through oral informations and then to process the informations to get understanding.
Okay, you can explore further. Yeah, you can explore further, yeah. And my question number three, what is the role of listener?
It should be active, Bapa. It means that the role of the listeners here as the person who are active to process the informations that they hear from the oral information.
Okay, you can explore further, right? Question number four, what is the relation between listener and speaker?
The relations between the listener and the speaker is that someone as the receiver and someone as the it is like receptive and I forget the other one, Papa, receptive and then productive. Someone who produce the information and someone who receive the information.
Okay, you can also explore this issue further, right? As listening is the counterpart of speaking in a dialogue, and it is no less important. Yeah, indeed, learning from the dialogue is less likely to occur as well people participate unless listening as well as speaking takes place. Yeah. Therefore, my last question is, what is the implications for one another? I mean, among those four issues or four questions I had asked you, what is the implication for one another? Because they are logically related and constitute a philosophy of listening. Please say something.
From the speakers and the listeners, the relations are they can build understanding for each other about what they are going, what they are talking about. So the speakers and the listeners are connected about the same topic or the same ideas.
Okay, good job. Once again, try to explore further to okay, make Papa. your answers to my question better, and you can add it in your discussion section. Okay?
Okay.
Thank you, Tia, for listening to me. Terima kasih, Prof. Agus.
Baik, terima kasih, Prof. Maaf, Pak Joko. Penguji berikut, Prof. Faridi, apa sudah bergabung? Belum, baik.
Sudah.
Halo, Prof. Faridi. Persilakan, waktu maksimal 10 menit. Silakan, Prof. Faridi. Waktu maksimal 10 menit.
Assalamualaikum, Prof.
Ya.
Silakan, Prof.
Assalamualaikum, ya.
Ya. Prof.
Ya. Siantrinya. Siap. Ya. Definitions and of the terminology of
I'm sorry, Prof.
Coba. My question is, please.
Yes, Prof. I'm sorry, I cannot hear you clearly, Prof.
Silakan dia.
I'm sorry, Prof. Can you reply the questions because it's just something, some trouble with. Hello, Prof. Yes, Prof.
Barangkali ya Mas Medi, sementara nanti kalau bisa masuk ini sekarang Profesor Dwi Rukmini dahulu, silakan Prof, waktu maksimal 10 menit.
Thank you very much Prof Agus Nuryatin untuk waktu yang diberikan kepada saya. First of all, I'm say congratulations to Mbak Diah Astriani for successfully completing your dissertation. And now you can be promoted today as a doctor of philosophy. Before I give my question to you, but actually I know the answer because you have consulted with me very many times. Yes. Okay, please do consider all the suggestion, yes, advices given by all the examiners when later on, okay, you revise your dissertation. My first suggestion is that, okay, on your structure, on your grammar, have you really checked the grammar in Grammarly Premium?
Yes, I did check the grammar by using Grammarly, but not the premium one, Prof.
Oh, I see. Especially the summary of your dissertation, which is written in these small books. Yeah, I found, okay, some crucial problem with your grammar. Please do revise them. Yeah. And then let us go to my questions. You said that for students of IKI PGRI Pontianak, they have problems when, okay, participating in listening comprehension lesson or subject, right? And then you choose two strategies for improving, okay, the bad condition, right? Yes, my question is, okay, how come so that you give your choices to advanced organizer and graphic organizers as the instrument of your study for improving that bad condition?
Okay, thank you for the questions, Prof. The reason why I combine these two kinds of organizers into one organization's presentations, it is because these two kinds of organizers have different form. The first, in advanced organizer, the information presented is in form of narrative, full narrative, and then the other graphic organizer is the, an organizer which present the information in form of graphs or pictures and also words and even sometimes simple sentences. But the considerations why I combine these two kinds of organizer because that when the students deal with the information in form of narrative, only narrative, it is afraid that the students will easy to get bored to the listen to the lecturer explanations. But it is contrary with the graphic organizer, where there is only a limited information provided. It means that the organizer in graphic informations in graphic organizer only in form of a graph or picture and words, sometimes simple sentences, and the students are expected to explore or to identify the key terminologies that are available in the organizer. So by combining these two kinds of organizer, hopefully that the informations in the narrative form provide sufficient informations, while the other graphic organizer provide the students with interesting picture or interesting graphs for them to have interest to listen for the lecturer's explanation.
Okay, good. Because when you answer the question from the examiners, you only concern with the advanced organizer, but not graphic organizer. Now I've got information why you also use graphic organizer as the completion of advanced organizer. Have you written them in your... Have you written them in your dissertation? Real estate? Not yet.
Not yet, bro.
Yeah, complete. Okay, it with that explanation. Yes. Okay, so when revise your dissertation, okay, complete it with your answer that you have just given to me. Okay. Number two, that is about the moderator variables. Can you give the reason why you state anxiety low and high as the moderator variable? What's your consideration?
Okay, thank you very much, Prof. The considerations why I choose listening anxiety, because that listening comprehensions is a complex process, Prof. It is where the students have lots of things to do in one activity. That's why the closest psychological factors that accompanying with this kind of activity is listening anxiety, Prof. And then for the reason why I separate it into high listening anxiety and low listening anxiety, I just want to make sure that whether the students have or experience the high level of anxiety or the low level of listening anxiety.
Okay, thank you. But after knowing that those low and high anxieties have given no correlation with the achievement of the students, what's your inference?
I'm sorry, Prof. Perhaps if I'm not mistaken, why the listening anxiety is there is no relation with the organizer that I'm used, Prof.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Prof. Why there is no correlation between the listening anxiety and the organizers that I'm using in this dissertations? Because that has resulted in the research findings that whether the students have high or low listening anxiety, their English their listening achievement still improve, while the researcher use the combinations of advanced and graphic organizer. It is because that listening anxiety is a multidimensional, where the source of the student anxiety can come from different aspects or different sources. Perhaps that most of the students feel feel anxious when they listen to the speed rate of the conversation, or they feel nervous when they afraid that the information did not, they cannot process the information very appropriately. And also, it also can come from the way of the lecturer's teaching. Perhaps the lecturer is too strict or too terlalu garang gitu. Jadi,
okay.
Yes.
Have you written that in your consideration of choosing the moderator variables?
Yes, Prof.
Especially in the discussion of the result.
Yes,
okay,
Prof.
Itself that, okay, there is no correlation between that variables, yes, with the result of your study. Okay. Yeah, add that, please. Will you?
Already, Prof. Yeah. In the discussion sessions and also in the conclusion.
Yeah, in the discussion.
Yes, Prof.
Yeah, in the discussion of findings.
Yes, Prof.
Okay, because you explain well here, but I cannot find the written explanation. Add that, please.
Okay, yeah. Prof.
Thank you very much. You are saved by the bell. Congratulations.
Thank yeah. you, Prof.
Welcome. Great.
Makasih.
Now, selesai, Prof.
Terima kasih, Prof. Biruk ini. Prof. Haridi, apakah sudah bisa tersambung? Halo, Prof. Haridi.
Saya bisa mendengar semuanya, tetapi dia tidak mendengar saya. Ya, halo.
Terdengar. Ya. Oke, okay, sudah mendengar.
I can hear you, Prof. Right now.
Saya. Oh.
Yang ini tidak dengar, Prof.
Halo, Prof. Haridi.
Tadi ya saya sudah tanya berkali-kali dia tidak mendengar saya. Jadi sudah sekarang bisa mendengar.
Iya, Prof. Bisa, Prof.
Oh, yang ini tidak mendengar. Sudah ya. Saya unmute ya. Sudah.
Tadi putus-putus, Prof.
Ini nggak dengar lagi.
Halo, Prof. Haridi. Halo. Ya, saya kira tadi yang Prof. Haridi sudah memberi skor nilai dan dia sudah menilai.
Prof. Haridi ya. Menelpon, bolehkah saya mengangkat?
Oh, silakan, silakan. Di ujian pakai, ya gitu, silakan.
Halo, Assalamualaikum, Prof. Halo. Masih menghubungkan. Halo.
Faridi mungkin sekarang di Jeddah ini, Pak.
Betulkah? Iya.
Enggak.
Ya, di Mekah.
Enggak, di rumah.
Masih tidak tersambung, Prof. Tadi masuk, diangkat, menghubungi saja, Prof. Tidak tersambung.
Bagaimana? Enggak? Tidak bisa komunikasi?
Tidak bisa, Prof. Masih memanggil, Prof.
Mohon tidak ditelepon dahulu, ini biar langsung bicara di Zoom saja. Karena malah tambah berat internetnya nanti.
Halo.
Halo, Prof.
Bisa mendengar saya?
Bisa, Prof.
Bisa.
Sudah, silakan.
Hilang lagi.
Terdengar, Prof. Monggo, Prof. Berisi.
Ya, gimana? Bisa mendengar?
Yo. Bisa terdengar, Prof. Silakan.
Dari tadi saya menanyakan itu hubungan antara EO, GO, dan listening anxiety. Coba. EO, GO, dan listening anxiety.
Okay, thank you very much, Prof. The relationship between the advanced organizer and the to the listening anxiety is that we provide the students information at the beginning of the lesson, where the students have enough information to be anchored to the new information that they will hear through listening. So when the students
bagaimana,
have
Mbak Dia?
When the students have sufficient information, so they will feel less anxious, they feel less nervous and afraid of being mistaken, Prof. That is why it is have correlations between those two organizer and to the students' listening anxiety. Ini bisa masuk, Prof. Video call-nya bisa masuk, Prof.
They feel less.
Dimatikan, Prof.
Yeah. What about this strategy?
Mohon maaf, Prof. Putus suaranya, Prof.
Of learning strategy.
I'm really sorry, Prof. Can you repeat it, Prof? Because
hello.
Hello. Mohon maaf, bisa diulangi, Prof?
Yeah, coba. What about the strategy? Learning strategy in listening compared with these two organizers. The learning strategy in listening comprehension combined with these two organizers, advanced organizer and graphic organizers.
Compared, Prof. Okay, the question is the comparison between the listening strategies used and the advanced organizer and graphic organizer, Prof.
Bagaimana, Mbak Dia?
Okay, Prof. Actually, the advanced organizer and the graphic organizer, it is part of the strategies that is used in this study, Prof. Hello, Prof. Yes, it is part of the strategy, but it is in form of organizer, Prof. So organizer itself is the strategies. Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, Prof.
Okay, so you said graphic strategy is what this is can graphic strategy in the form of listening. How can you explain?
Excuse me,
graphic Paul? Strategy.
Graphic strategies. Graphic strategies and Ya, Bro. Halo. Gimana, Prof? Suaranya putus-putus, Prof. Iya, yang di Zoom meeting suaranya putus-putus, Prof. Yes, Prof. Halo.
Bisa dengar saya, Mbak Dia?
Bisa, Prof.
Ya? Oke. Okay. Ya, graphic strategy, ya, what about, karena graphic is just
progress, ya,
no problem, graphic strategy kan biasanya dalam bentuk image,
yes, bro. Suara latar belakangnya terlalu nyaring, Prof. Oke, saya coba menjawab nih, Prof. Halo, Prof. Halo. Oke, saya coba jawab nih, Prof. Oke, graphic. Graphic strategies. Well, actually, graphic is only the form. Yes, Prof. Graphic is only the form of the organizer, Prof. So it is just how to differentiate the narrative form of the organizer and the graphic form of the organizer. But from what I have read in also Ball and also Baron, who proposed the graphic organizer, that there is no theories or there is no sentences which mention that graphic organizer or advanced organizer is some kinds of like teaching media. It is a kind of strategies, but it is in form of graphic and in form of narrative. The strategies is just to provide sufficient information related to the topic that are that the students will learn at that time. So it was given in at the beginning of the lesson, Prof.
Oke, jadi bisa juga dipakai ya di sini ya. Jadi bisa. Graphic strategy dalam listening comprehension.
Yes, Prof. Bisa, ya? Yes, Prof. Mm-hmm. Yes, Prof.
Iya, iya. Oke, oke. Itu yang I just want to clarify this one.
Oke, okay, Prof.
Okay, thank you very much. Good luck for you. Yeah.
You're welcome, Prof. I'm really sorry, Prof.
It's okay, no worry.
Oke, okay, Prof.
Terima kasih, Prof. Agus. Matur nuwun.
Hey. Terima kasih, Prof. Aridi. Dengan demikian, maka pertanyaan dan sanggahan dari para penguji promosi dalam promosi doktor ini selesai.
Ketua penguji menunda ujian untuk memberikan waktu kepada para penguji melaksanakan rapat yudisium.
Untuk memberikan waktu kepada tim penguji dalam menentukan hasil ujian. Dengan ini ujian promosi doktor atas nama Saudari Diah Astrianti SPD MPD dinyatakan ditunda.
Rapat yudisium dipimpin oleh Ketua Penguji. Kemudian promosi doktor pendidikan dilanjutkan kembali. Ketua penguji membuka kembali ujian promosi doktor pendidikan.
Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan atas nama Saudari Diah Astrianti SPD MPD dinyatakan dibuka kembali. Berikut saya bacakan berita acara ujian disertasi tahap 2. Pada hari ini, Selasa, tanggal 9 bulan November tahun 2021, di Pascasarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang, UNES, telah diselenggarakan ujian disertasi tahap 2 atas nama Diah Astrianti SPD MPD pada program studi ilmu pendidikan bahasa Pascasarjana UNES dengan disertasi yang berjudul The Effect of Advanced Organizer, Graphic Organizer, and Combination of Advanced Organizer and Graphic Organizer on Listening Comprehension of Students with Different Anxiety Levels. Setelah dilaksanakan ujian dan dilaksanakan rapat penguji, keputusan tim penguji menyatakan bahwa Diah Astrianti SPD MPD dinyatakan lulus sebagai doktor pendidikan. Dr. Diah Astrianti MPD adalah doktor ke-676 lulusan UNES atau doktor ke-133 lulusan Prodi Ilmu Pendidikan Bahasa Pascasarjana UNES dengan masa studi 4 tahun 2 bulan. Karya ilmiah disertasi diberi penghargaan dengan nilai A, sehingga IPK menjadi 3,72. Hasil akhir ujian promosi doktor pendidikan dengan predikat kelulusan sangat memuaskan. Atas nama Ketua Penguji Sekretaris Profesor Dr. Agus Nuratin MUM, pembacaan selesai.
Terima kasih, Pak.
Ketua Penguji mempersilahkan promotor untuk menyampaikan kesan dan pesan.
Promotor dipersilahkan menyampaikan kesan dan pesan. Suaranya,
Ya, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam, Prof. Agus Nuryatin yang sangat mulia, yang sudah dawi saya untuk memberikan kesan dan pesan. You want me to give it in English or in bahasa? Or mix? Ibu?
Yes, Prof.
Ya. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, just now, the chairman of the examination board asked me to give my kesan and pesan to Ibu Dr. Diah Astrianti, Ibu Doktor yang baru. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Anda sudah mendapat satu title di depan nama Ibu Doktor. Alhamdulillah. Jangan lupa nanti sujud syukur atas ridho dan barakah Allah Subhanahu wa taala, Anda lulus dengan memuaskan. Omi, Ibu Doktor Diah is a patient woman. Why I say patient is because whenever I give suggestion or after the close examination with lots of comments or revision, she never complains. That's great, showing that you are matured, that all the suggestions are for you, yeah, to make betterment of your dissertation. For me, you are great.
Thank you, Prof.
Instead of, yeah, that she is patient, she is also a superwoman. Why super? Because now she is expecting a baby. Well, she has to complete her dissertation. Furthermore, she is now sitting, okay, there, yes, to defend what he has just written for her dissertation. That's great. Do you know why? Maybe you are helped by, okay, you're expecting baby. Yeah. That's really barakah for you.
I mean,
yeah, besides the support, yes, okay, the encouragement given by your husband. You know that her husband has just achieved his doctorate degree of this university, yes, particularly in the sport S3 program. Yes, so you have a very happy family because in your family, you have two doctors, your husband and you yourself, and later on will be, okay, your future child. Yes. Selamat Ibu. And I also will say congratulations to the University of IKIP PGRI Pontianak, because, okay, this institution is now added with one doctor, Ibu Dr. Diah Astrianti. And I'm sure she will contribute more in your institution. Selamat Bapak Rektor dan semuanya. And selamat juga for the family of Bapak Diah, yes, karena semuanya ini tidak akan berhasil tanpa support dari seluruh anggota keluarga, including Bapak. Selamat Bapak, jangan lupa nanti bersyukur.
Ya, Prof. Terima kasih, Prof.
And okay, Ibu Dr. Diah, this is not the end of your struggle.
Ya, professionally.
Ya, yeah. Selamat ya Bapak.
Terima kasih, Prof.
Bapak punya istri yang sangat luar biasa. Ya. Yeah. Ujian sedang expecting a baby. Itu kalau tidak super, tidak bisa, Bapak. So, cintailah dia sepenuh hati. Oke. Okay. Ibu Dr. Diah, this is not the end of your struggle professionally, but consider this achievement as the start to show that you are a real doctor of philosophy in English education. Artinya, please write a lot for reputable journals, do lots of researches, and I'm sure that you will be very, very successful with your doctor achievement. Selamat, Ibu.
Thank you, Prof.
On the behalf of UNES, particularly Pasca Sarjana, I also ask for your apologize. Who knows that in responding or in giving pelayanan buat Anda is not so satisfactory. Yes, kadang-kadang. Tetapi Anda tidak jengkel, berarti tidak pernah ada yang tidak memuaskan. Ya, yeah, all are satisfied for the services we give to you. Yeah. Okay. Selamat, sukses.
Thank you.
I love you.
Yeah. I love you too.
Sampun, Bapak Tua. Profesor Agus Nuryatin, that's all from me. Thank you very much. Sampun, Bapak.
Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan atas nama Dr. Diah Astrianti, MPD, ditutup oleh Ketua Penguji.
Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin. Dan dengan seizin Bapak Ibu serta hadirin sekalian, ujian promosi doktor pendidikan atas nama Dr. Diah Astrianti, MPD, secara resmi saya nyatakan ditutup.
Alhamdulillah.
Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Upacara selesai dilanjutkan dengan pemberian ucapan selamat. Ucapan selamat diawali dari Ketua Penguji.
Baik, mewakili Ketua Penguji dan sebagai sekretaris penguji, saya mengucapkan selamat pada saudari Dr. Diah Astrianti, MPD, yang kali ini secara resmi saudari sudah meraih gelar derajat akademik tertinggi sebagai doktor. Mudah-mudahan berkah dan memberi manfaat kepada sebanyak-banyaknya makhluk Allah.
Amin.
Selamat juga pada suami Dr. Diah. Ini kalau tidak salah ini juga sudah dokter ini ya?
Sudah, Pak.
Dr. Susiah Porja Daryanto.
Agustus.
Ya, Prof.
Selamat dan ini.
Ya, terima kasih, Prof.
Sudah imbang berarti sama-sama memperjuangkan diri sendiri dan pasangan hidupnya untuk bisa lulus sebagai dokter. Ini pasangan yang menurut saya luar biasa. Sama-sama kuliah dan lulus di waktu hampir yang sama. Relatif sama. Ini luar biasa. Kalau begitu saya tidak lagi bertanya rasanya dokter kepada siapa, kan ini sudah sama-sama. Kepada Susiah saya sudah tanya gimana rasanya dokter itu. Sebagian juga nanti kepada dia juga kita bertanya gimana rasanya dokter. Akan sama-sama merasakan dokter. Nah, kemudian pada anak dokter dia sama dengan Susia juga selamat. Lalu kepada lembaga tempat bekerja itu juga selamat karena sudah menambah dokter. Dan tentu harapan pesan saya juga saudara berdua sudah bisa lulus dari pasca sarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang dan mudah-mudahan silaturahmi itu berlanjut, artinya saudara berdua bisa mengabarkan hal-hal yang baik yang ada di pasca sarjana dan di UNES ini sehingga ke depan teman, kolega, atau mungkin anak buah atau siapapun bisa ikut merasakan, menikmati pendidikan di pasca sarjana UNES. Baik, sekali lagi selamat dan mudah-mudahan menambah berkah buat Dr. Diah Astrianti dan keluarga. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Soekarno MSI.
Skip, Mbak, skip.
Baik, dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Januarius Mujianto MHUM.
Terima kasih. Untuk saudari bukan Prof. Vendus lagi ya, dokter ya. Dr. Diah Astrianti ya, saya sampaikan selamat ya, ini puncak ya dari apa pengabdian Anda pada pendidikan ya, terutama untuk diri sendiri dulu, untuk suami dan untuk anak dan calon anak ya. Salam ya, anak yang akan lahir ya. Oke, okay. Ya selamat, dan ini akan menjadi starting point bagi Anda untuk lebih mantap lagi mengabdi di institusi tempat Anda berlabuh itu. Mudah-mudahan dengan gelar doktor ini Anda dapat memberikan yang lebih banyak kepada lembaga, kepada nusa bangsa, kepada keluarga ya, dan selain itu kapan jadi profesor gitu ya, ya karena ada mahasiswa dari sini yang baru beberapa tahun yang lalu lulus, hari tanggal 11 besok saya diundang untuk menghadiri pengukuhan guru besar ya.
Siapa? Oke, siapa?
Ya. Mungkin angkatan Anda ya. Ya, angkatan Anda ya. Listiani dari UKSW itu ya. Listiani kan baru belum lama lulus ya. Ternyata ya, tanggal 11 besok itu dia pengukuhan guru besar ya. Okay. Nah, ini akan disusul dia Astrianti untuk dianggap,
amin,
untuk dipromosikan sebagai guru besar. Selamat ya. Oke, okay, mudah-mudahan doa Anda berhasil dikabulkan oleh Tuhan. Dan sekali lagi sampaikan salam saya pada suami, pada lembaga Anda mengabdi. Selamat ya kami ucapkan. Mudah-mudahan sukses akan terus-menerus Anda nikmati pada waktu-waktu yang akan datang. Terima kasih, Mbak Ani.
Terima kasih, Prof. Dilanjutkan oleh Dr. Eko Handoyo, MSI.
Ya, terima kasih, Mbak Ani, Bu Dr. Diah Astrianti. Patience is the key to success. Kesabaran penjenengan.
Yes, Bro.
Mengawal your husband ya, Pak. Suami, mengawal ya, mendidik anak, juga sabar diberi bimbingan, masukan, koreksi dari pembimbing, akhirnya membuahkan hasil, dan hari ini menjenengan dikukuhkan sebagai Dr. Diah Astrianti. Sekali lagi selamat ya Bu, selamat pada Bapak, suami, anak, dan keluarga besar IKI PGRI Pontianak. Nggih, matur nuwun Mbak Ani.
Terima kasih Pak.
Terima kasih Bapak. Dilanjutkan oleh Dr. Joko Sutopo, MSI.
Pak Joko.
Lagi.
Wah, Pak Joko Sutopo. Pak Joko Sutopo.
Dipersilahkan Bapak.
Ya, ya, terima kasih. Dr. Diah Astrianti. Alhamdulillah hari ini Allah menghendaki Anda lulus dokter, dan itu berarti Allah memberikan karunia-Nya kepada Anda. Semoga Anda bahagia dan bisa berbuat sesuatu yang lebih baik untuk IKIP Pontianak. IKIP PGRI ya. Pontianak ya. Oke. Okay. Ya, selamat ya, ya. Congratulations. I hope you can see again in other opportunity in a better situation. Okay? Good job. Ya, dia. Ya. Thank you.
Bapak, dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini, MPD.
Nuhun, Mbak. Halo.
Ya,
Dr. Dia.
Ya, Prof.
Ya. Selamat. Congratulations. Ya. Alhamdulillah Allah sudah memberi barokah kepada Anda. Mudah-mudahan ini benar-benar barokah untuk your future life. Not only for your family, but for all people in the world. Ya. Selamat, sukses, lebih bahagia.
Amin.
Okay, you have done a good job. Great.
Thank you, Bro. Yeah.
Sampun, Mbak. Matur nuwun.
Terima kasih, Bro.
I love you. Yeah.
Dan kepada Bapak Ibu tamu undangan, dipersilakan untuk memberikan ucapan selamat. Silakan Bapak Ibu.
Congratulations Mbak Dia, Bu Dr. Dia Astriati, MPD. You are so inspiring. Semoga thank saya you, segera menyusul.
Amin, Allahumma amin. Mbak Yus.
Halo.
Mbak Dia, congratulations ya. Mohon maaf aku enggak pakai kamera nih.
Yeah.
Dokter Dia Astrianti, selamat juga.